morning, church, and welcome to the celebration of worship. We will begin with the lighting of the Christ candle. We light this candle as a reminder that Jesus Christ is the light of the world and walks with us each and every day. Thanks be to God. Welcome one and all as we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Eastertide. The phrase, where two or three are gathered, is particularly apt this morning, as I am here as your presider, Meredith Fraser, and I am accompanied by our musician, Stephanie Freeman, and by our able computer whiz, Pamela Canning. And we are happy to be with you today in Mary's absence as you celebrate Mother's Day and Christian Family Sunday in whatever way you are able today. Regarding the life and work of the congregation, there are some announcements. A donation to the General Fund has been made in loving memory of Lynn Hale from Jean, Muriel, and Bill. The official board meeting, which was scheduled for next Sunday, has been canceled, and they will let you know when that is happening. Thank you to everyone who continues to support the work of this congregation and of the broader church through their weekly offerings. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. These are the words we hear from the 100th Psalm. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, bless his name. For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. And I invite you to join with me in the gathering prayer as it is shown on your screen. Friends, let us pray. Love everlasting. You are the frame within which our lives are woven and take shape. You are the dream that keeps our hope alive and our spirits strong. You are the future, beckoning us to live with purpose and goodwill in the day that is. You are God. In you we live and move and have our being. May we live this day with joy and thanksgiving. May we praise your name forever. Amen. And we are grateful to Stephanie this morning for her selection of psalms, which are all meant to lift our spirits and bring joy to our day. Jesus bids us shine.
Your soul for new.
Our psalm this morning is the 112th psalm, and I would invite you to read it responsibly with me. Blessed are those who fear God, who greatly delight in God's commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Riches and plenty will be in their house, their righteousness enduring forever. They are a light in the darkness for the upright, being gracious, compassionate, and just. It goes well with those who lend generously, who conduct their affairs with justice. For the righteous will never be shaken. They will be kept in remembrance forever. They will not live in fear of bad news. With resolute heart, they trust in God. Their heart is steady. They do not fear. In the end, they will see their enemies' downfall. They distribute freely to the poor, their righteousness enduring forever. They will hold up their heads in honor. And again, I would say how good it is when people, I know it says biblically that God loveth a cheerful giver. And sometimes in these days, it's hard to give with that good cheer. And yet you continue to do so. And on behalf of the congregation of St. Paul United, its staff, and all the congregation, I thank you for that. Let us now dedicate your offering in prayer. Gracious God, holy friend, you have given us the gifts of a beautiful creation, the good green earth and the bountiful sea. On this spring morning, we thank you for your gifts to humanity and to offer our gifts in return, so that the ministry of this church will continue to grow and be a blessing to this community and to the world. Accept our gifts, we pray, for we offer them sincerely, with gratitude, with praise, and with thanksgiving. Amen. And our Old Testament lesson this morning is a reading from the prophet Isaiah, reading from the 58th chapter, "Your light shall break forth." Is not this the fast that I choose? To loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke. Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and to bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own kin. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help and he will say, "Here I am." And reading also from the Gospel according to Matthew. The passage that follows immediately upon the Beatitudes, which are so dear to our hearts. And these are passages and phrases that remind us of how we are loved. And Jesus said to them, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how can the saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, how are you bearing up? Have you ordered the lobster for the traditional Mother's Day feast? Have you packed the picnic basket and collected the fishing rods for the first spring outing of the clan? Have you made your special burgers and Granny's potato salad for the crowd expected in the backyard? Maybe not so much. There are a lot of mothers missing their children today, and a lot of children missing their mothers. During the course of a usual year, there are many days when we naturally expect to congregate with family, and Mother's Day is one of them. It helps that Mother's Day often coincides with the first fresh, delightful, greening days of spring. And by the end of it, there are often rosy cheeks and red noses because we packed everything but the sunscreen. Again, maybe not so much today. So here we are again, all over again, and our spirits are taking a beating. And we are feeling bereft, and we are in urgent need of good news. May is a month that can hold both present celebrations and precious memories. For clergy, at least in our denomination, these memories often include their ordination into ministry. My own ordination would have been 28 years ago this month. And yes, it was followed by a great gathering of the clan at a great lobster feast. But I digress. What I'm remembering today is another ordination service in another year when the preacher was the Right Reverend Clarence M. Nicholson, born and bred in Sydney Mines, former moderator of the United Church of Canada, officer of the Order of Canada, and for 25 years principal of the Pine Hill Divinity Hall, precursor to today's Atlantic School of Theology. Nicholson was known as a mighty orator. And the words he spoke that day to the wide-eyed and all too innocent ordinands about to embark on their lifelong ministry journeys, I have never forgotten. "Preach the good news," Dr. Nicholson said. And then he thundered, "Preach the good news." And yet again, "Preach the good news." I have never forgotten his charge that day, though I have often forgotten to do it within this United Church of ours. The United Church of Canada, UCC, or Unending Committees and Causes, as one jester described us. And sometimes it feels that way. We are so busy saving the world, toppling the social order, and decrying privilege that the good news gets lost in the shuffle. When in 30 years of ministry, it has often occurred to me that the folks in the pews of a Sunday morning just really want to hear that God loves them. And I think today is just such a day. Even when your pew is your living room couch or your unmade bed, on this ninth day of May, in the year of our Lord 2021, here it is, hot off the presses, top of your inbox, you are loved, you are precious, you count. That is the good news of the gospel today, my friends, and of the prophet, and of the song. You are loved, you are precious, you matter. Thanks be. In Psalm 112, we read the phrase together, in fear of bad news. And the complete verse reads, they will not live in fear of bad news. With resolute heart, they trust in God. The righteousness will not live in fear of bad news, we are told. Their heart is steady. They do not fear. With resolute heart, they trust in God. Wherever we look, we can name situations, trends, developments, and events that we might name as bad news. So much so, especially this year, this month, that it becomes easier and easier to live in a state of constant apprehension of what may come next. Does this sound remotely like a people who will not live in fear of bad news? Does this sound even vaguely like a people who, with resolute heart, trust in God about everything? You are the salt of the earth, we hear from the gospel today. You are the light of the world. Your light shall break forth like the dawn, sings Isaiah. Your healing shall spring up quickly. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs. You shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water whose waters never fail. Again and again throughout the scriptures, we receive messages of encouragement and inspiration. Morale boosters of the first order. Messages that point us clearly toward a lived attitude, not of fear and scarcity, but of joy and abundance. However it is that we understand God to be, divine ruler, faithful father, cosmic energy, holy redeemer or holy friend. It is the attitude that we bring to the world each day that reveals most plainly what gives us strength and carries us through. We are grown-ups. We make choices all the time. We can make the choice to live with intention, practicing hope, faith, and love in the daily round of our lives. We can make the choice not to live in fear of bad news, but in the assurance that the world and our own lives are ripe with blessing. Imagine if every child went to bed hearing the words, "You are the light of the world," and woke up every morning to hear once again, "You are the light of the world." Imagine if you went to bed every night hearing the words, "You are the light of the world," and woke up every morning to hear once again, "You are the light of the world." How could we ever live in fear and defeat if that was the understanding we had of our own value, our own worth in the whole scheme of things? "You are the light of the world," Jesus says to us. "Let your light shine," Jesus says to us. The words that Jesus speaks from the gospel today about light and salt and the value of each human life are found in a portion of Matthew that we call the Sermon on the Mount. The wisdom that emerges from those few chapters of the gospel is so illustrative of Jesus' life and teaching that the legendary Mahatma Gandhi once commented, "I should not care if it was proved by someone that the man called Jesus never lived, and that what was narrated in the Gospels was a figment of the writer's imagination, for the Sermon on the Mount would still be true for me." Friends, let us go forth today confident that our lives are of value, that we matter, and that we are called to live in the arena of hope and good news that Jesus embodied. Let us not be weighed down by our own burdens or the burdens of the world. Jesus bids us shine. When the psalmist speaks, may he be speaking of you and of me. "For the righteous will never be shaken, they will be remembered forever. They will not live in fear of bad news, because with resolute heart they trust in God. Their heart is steady, they do not fear. They give freely to the poor, their righteousness enduring forever. And they will hold up their heads with honor." Beloved of God, for so you are. This is the good news of the word today. And it is for us. Hallelujah.
I am a bird, desire to
Now let us come together as the people of God. Let us pray. On this green spring day, with the carols of the earth and all its creatures ringing around us, we pray to you, O Lord of earth, sea, and sky. Help us to flourish as the most abundant fruits of your garden. Help us to be beautiful and strong for you. Guide our words, our actions, and our thoughts, that they may be worthy of your hope in us. Hold us close in your loving arms as a mother does her children, and embrace us with your tender care. Bless the mothers within this congregation, those watching online, and in all the other places, including our hearts. Bless those new to parenthood, just finding their way, mothers and fathers both. Bless all the families that we represent here today, and all the ways we come together to support and encourage and delight each other as the whole people of God. Bless those who create their own families in challenging situations of foster care, group homes, shelters, and prisons. Bless the ones who have stood in as parents in the absence of others. Holy Friend, on this Christian Family Sunday, bless the ones we love. Keep them safe from harm, wherever they may be. In the wide world, gracious God, bless those who are cold or hungry or afraid today. Bless those who are lonely. Bless those who are sick or sad or coping with heartache. Bless those who are grieving. We pray especially for the family of Karen Ferguson, including her niece Mary, shepherd of this congregation. We pray for all who have experienced the death of a loved one in the year that has passed. In the absence of the traditional ways of mourning, the storytelling, the tender condolences, the shared memories, the laughter. May they be held in the love of the God that is love and derive such comfort as they may. We remember too today the 26 men who died in the Westray mine explosion 29 years ago. For some, that loss is still fresh, and the memory remains strong for all Pictonians. God of abundance and new life, bring us into this new season of the earth, full of care and compassion for each other, for our neighbors near and far, and for the planet we call home. Guard our words, mind our careless tongues, fill our hearts with thanksgiving and compassion, clothe us with joy. We pray for your help with the worries and troubles that keep us from living the good news. Give to us laughter. Help us to know and to radiate your joy to others. Help us to live in the peace of Christ. God, our Savior, Holy Friend, be Be with all your children and the whole creation across the face of the earth today. And may more of the peace of Christ take root, grow strong and flourish, beginning here today with us. These are our Sunday prayers, O God. Receive them and send them back to us in word and deed, that ours may be the faith that issues in action and love. Bless and keep us, each one, in Jesus' name. Amen. And now let us offer together the prayer that many of us learned from childhood and recite with our night prayers and our morning offerings. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Brighten the corner where you are indeed. Listen to these words that echo to us from the pages of time. Be strong and of good courage. Do not fear or be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. And wherever you go or stay in the week to come, may the peace of Christ attend you. May the love of God surround you, and may the Holy Spirit keep you this day. And and evermore. Amen.